The number of overdose deaths are down here in Surry County, and a lot of that is thanks to Narcan becoming more readily accessible. But now emergency responders are dealing with a new type of challenge in this fight against addiction. An epidemic that's not only growing.
What's so sad about this? We have individuals out here that we have run in cardiac arrest as many as 5 to 7 times.
But evolving.
But now we're seeing so many different mixtures with the medication. For example, we're starting to see heroin and fentanyl mixed together here. They've started mixing benzos and seizure medications.
In 2017, Surry County had 237 overdoses and responders used Narcan 131 times. Last year, the number of overdoses went up to 371 and responders used Narcan 204 times. But actual overdose deaths are down from 55 to 32 last year.
Narcan is so readily available now, has made a great difference in the outcome of survival.
Emergency responders aren't stopping there. They're now using maps to track where these calls are coming from.
And those have been, you know, greatly beneficial, especially to law enforcement, and trying to get out here and find where these folks are selling all this.
With the ultimate hope of getting to the heart of this problem.
Our concern is we still haven't found a way to get a hold on it, to find out how to stop it. You know, the resources available to deal with addiction are very poor right now.
As emergency responders work on ways to get the number of overdoses here in Surry County down, they're faced with another challenge, so-called Narcan parties. The Emergency Services Director John Shelton tells me that last year they responded to one of those parties and found 8 people alone had overdosed. Reporting in Surry County, I'm Janae Lewis, WXII 12 News.